Where's Frida?
Sir! This is my niece. It is a pleasure to make her acquaintance. My words were not an introduction, but a warning. Go in. At once! Sir, you are impertinent.
I am not a peasant, and I acknowledge only one lord. Both my nieces will be instructed never to speak to you again.
Haven't you got us into enough trouble? No supper and early to bed. Is that all you ever think about?
Yourself?
Don't be so greedy. But if anyone comes and finds you gone, there will be a terrible scene. No one is going to notice, stupid. I don't know what you're complaining about. All you have to do is go to sleep. I'm not asking you to come with me. I wouldn't dare.
I know you wouldn't. You're scared of your own shadow and terrified of dear Uncle Gustav.
Yes, I am.
Well, I'm not. I don't care if he does find me gone.
The Count will protect me. Frida, I beg you, think about what you're doing. Everyone says he's a wicked man. What about it?
Who wants to be good if being good is singing hymns and praying all day long?
He's doing what's best for us, I'm sure.
It might be best for you.
It's not for me.
I'm going, and you might as well stop arguing about it.
And I warn you, if you dare tell on me, Frida, you know I wouldn't do that.
I'm just telling you. You know what will happen if you do.
Stop it, you're hurting me.
Not half as much as I will if you don't keep quiet.
They're all in bed now. No one will notice.
And don't lie awake waiting for me.
And don't worry.
I shan't be long.
Frida, I beg you, don't go.
I warned you once.
You know what I'll do to you if you make any trouble, don't you?